Sound design.
I want to introduce you to a couple of neat tools in SATlive called Live Ad Trace and Perfect Addition Trace, and how you can use these tools in your main sub-alignment. So I've got SATlive open here, and let me make sure that I've got everything cleared out of my X32. All right, so let's play my main first. Set the delay. I'll just call this M-pre. And let's go ahead and zoom into the low end. Now let's listen to the sub. Cool, so I'll just freeze that because the live add trace and perfect addition trace work in conjunction with whichever trace is live right now. The live trace, I know it's confusing. The names in SATlive and the labels for things are not the easiest to comprehend, but this is the situation. This blue trace here is the live trace. The live add trace is going to add this blue live trace to a saved quick trace, this green one in this case. There is a trick to use a quick trace as the live trace, so that you can use things that you've saved already as quick traces and add them together and use virtual time shift and that kind of stuff. But I'll talk about that in a future video. Okay, so what is live add trace? Well, let me just go ahead and turn it on and show you what I mean. First, I need to make sure that I have the select fixed trace as this one I just saved in pre. And then I'll click on show live add trace. Now, if yours doesn't look yellow like this, because originally mine was black, which doesn't help very much with a black background, you can go to trace offset, then live addition, and change it here. Okay, so what is this yellow trace that we're looking at? Well, this is a comprehensive addition of the two signals taking phase into account. So where we have this phase offset here, you can see that we don't have summation, right? So this is doing some of the math for us and letting us know, hey, when you turn these two speakers on together at this microphone position, this is the result that you're going to get. So it just saves us a little bit of time so we don't have to measure main, then sub, then turn them on together and save that trace. We can just measure main and sub, turn on live addition trace, and then we can actually manipulate things and watch the live add trace in real time. The next thing I wanted to show you is show perfect addition trace. So this is just like live trace, except it does not take phase into account. And again, if your trace doesn't look pink like mine, so it's really easy to see in a black background, just go to trace, layout, perfect addition, and then you can change the color. So what do we have now here? This pink trace is the perfect possible addition. This would be the best possible outcome if we had perfect phase alignment throughout the crossover region of our main and our sub. This is what we would get to. And then remember, our yellow one is the reality. So the pink one is now our target. That's the goal we would like to hit. That's what's possible if we can get our phase aligned. And the yellow is where we're at right now. So what this allows us to do is just measure the sub, for example, and start moving it around the room or adjusting delay or put a polarity inversion and watch and see if we can get this live add trace to line up with this pink trace. So what I might do in the next step then is I might continue to measure the sub and start adding delay and see if I can get the live add trace to get closer to the perfect addition trace while at the same time monitoring the phase. Now in this case, I can tell that probably where I need to add delay is actually the main. So I probably want to do this backwards. So let's start over again, measure the sub first, and then the main. All right, so now we'll change the fixed trace to my sub pre. And we will start a new measurement of just the main. All right, so here's pretty much what we had before, except now my main is the live trace. So now I can start adding delay to my main and see what changes I'm gonna get in the live add trace. Let's just add 1 millisecond of delay. All right, there we go. So adding a little bit of delay, we can see that my main phase has started coming down towards the sub, and this yellow trace, my live add trace, is getting closer to the perfect addition trace. So let's keep adding delay until my live add trace is as close as possible to my perfect addition trace in the peak. Cool, I think we did it. This yellow trace, the live add trace, is now pretty much perfectly on top of this pink trace. And I ended up with 2.7 milliseconds of delay. And you remember in the last video using Smart, I ended up with about 2.6 milliseconds of delay. So just another method to pretty much arrive at the same result. And now we can verify this by turning them both on together. Let's see if I can move this live add trace to a quick trace though. All right, so here, copy add trace to quick trace. I'll put it in this last one. And then I'll turn off live add trace and perfect addition trace. So this sort of tan guy here is our perfect addition. This is now main with 2.7 milliseconds. A delay. Now let's turn both speakers on together. That's interesting. Our summation of both of them on together is actually higher than the live add trace and where the perfect addition trace said it would be. For some reason, it looks like there was an offset, but not in the live add trace. In these two traces, there's an offset of 2 dB. In the live add trace, there's not. And I think that's because I didn't have this checked. Use offset in calculation of live add trace. So when we started, one thing I forgot to do was look over here and notice that there's an offset of 2 dB. So that's why our perfect addition trace is now 2 dB off. So I'll press the T key until I get to the live add trace. I'll offset it by 2 dB. There we go. Now it makes sense. So now we can see our result, this blue line of having main and sub on together, is now the same as the live add trace. So just proving that the live add trace math was correct. Okay, so that's how you can use live add trace and perfect addition trace in SATlive to view how your main and sub are going to sum together and how it can help you make adjustments along the way. In the next video, I want to look at the delay suggestion tool, which might help you do this even faster.
Sound design.